book of Joshua. Chapter number 2. Minister Lewis read this morning. Chapter 2. Let us begin reading at verse number 1.
Joshua chapter 2,
yes,
verse 1.
Come on.
And Joshua the son of Nun,
yes,
sent out of Shittim 2 men to spy secretly, saying, go view the land,
yes,
even Jericho.
Mm-hmm.
And they went and came into the harlot's house named Rahab,
yes,
and lodged there.
Yes.
And it was told the king of Jericho, saying, behold,
mm-hmm,
there came men to hither tonight of the king of Israel to search out the country.
Yes.
And the king of Jericho sent unto Rahab, saying, bring forth the men that are come to thee,
yes,
which are entered into thine house,
uh-huh,
for they be come to search out all the country.
Yes.
And the woman took the 2 men and hid them,
mm-hmm,
and said thus, there came men unto me, but I wist not whence they were. And it came to pass about the time of the shutting of the gate,
yes,
when it was dark, the men went out. Whither the men went, I would not pursue after them quickly, for ye shall overtake them.
Yes.
But she had brought them up to the roof of the house,
yes,
and hid them with the stalks of flax, which she had laid in order upon the roof.
Yes.
And the men pursued after them the way to Jordan unto the fords. And as soon as they which pursued after them were gone out, they shut the gate. And before they were laid down, she came up unto them upon the roof.
Now go over to the 22nd. No, let's go up to the 19th verse.
19th verse. And it shall be that whosoever shall go out of the doors of thy house,
yes,
unto the street,
mm-hmm,
his blood shall be upon his head, and we will be guiltless, and whosoever shall be with thee in the house, his blood shall be on our head, if any hand be upon him. And if thou,
keep reading, keep going,
and if thou utter this our business, then we will be quit of thine oath, which thou hast made us unto swear. And she said, according unto your words.
According to your words, yes.
So be it.
So be it, yes.
And she sent them away.
Uh-huh.
And they departed.
Mm-hmm.
And she bound the scarlet line.
In the window.
In the window.
Verse number three. And the king of Jericho sent unto Rahab, saying, bring forth the men that are come to thee, which are entered into thine house, for they be come to search out all the country. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
You're going to have to learn how to outlive your past. Touch your other neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Bishop's going to preach. You're going to listen.
And you're not listening.
On how to outlive
your past.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray that you would speak a word to us, that you would open up our eyes, give us wisdom and insight, challenge us, change us, rearrange us, catapult us to that next level. We thank you for this now in the name of Jesus. Amen. As you're taking your seat, say, outlive your past. We've been declaring in Church of the Lord's Harvest that we have entered into the decade of destiny, that promises are yet on the way. We've been declaring that doors have been opened, and we are about to enter into one of the best times in our life. In order to do that, believer, we would stop parenthetically for this particular session this morning to let you know that in order for you to have a glorious future, You've got to learn how to let your past be your past.
Amen.
I'm going to say it one more time. In order for you to have the future that God wants you to have, you've got to learn how to allow your past situations to be past situations. You've got to learn how to let where you came from be where you came from and not where you're going.
Right.
You've got to learn how to release all of that stuff so that you can walk into what God says is going to be new. This is the Christ kind of living that God says that we ought to have. That if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. He says to us that old things are what? And behold, I'm making all things. We declare this scripture all the time, but this is the Christ kind of living that God wants us to live, is the Christ kind of being that he wants us to be. And the truth be told, many of us have been living beneath our privileges because we've been living in an old situation, in old paradigms, in old relationships, while all the time our declaration has become new. But this year, this decade, I'm declaring unto you that if you let it go, God says that you can have it.
Right.
I'm going to talk to you, I'm going to touch a neighbor and say, neighbor. If you let it go, God says that you can have it. It does not matter where you came from. Doesn't matter what your educational status is. Doesn't matter how much you make, where you live, what you drove, where you worked, how they handled you, how they mishandled you. If you let all of that stuff go, God says you can have the best of it. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, you can have the best of it. Say it one more time. Say, you can have the best of it. Many of you struggle in your life because you are trying to overcome your past. Doesn't matter how many new years you go into, seems like you have old year on your mind. Doesn't matter how many old days you go in, or new days you go into, you have old days on your mind. Bible says morning by morning, what? Y'all quiet in here. Morning by morning, what? If he's giving you new mornings on a new day, then why are you bringing up the same old condemnation that has been haunting you and plaguing you this entire time? Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, God said new. He said this was the decade of destiny, didn't he? Y'all all right in here today? Touch your neighbor and say, God says new. So God says, stop thinking about your old. I don't know. I'm going to drive this Mack truck through here because some of y'all are trying to hold on to your old stuff. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, God says new. That means you got to have a new mentality. You got to have a new language. You got to have a new way of living. You got to have a new faith. You got to have a new trust. You got to have a new dependence on him. Because guess what? He ain't trying to pass out that old stuff that he was passing out in 2010. Let your neighbor say, neighbor, God's got a blessing for you in 2011. Y'all quiet. Say it one more time. Say, it's for you in 2011. My God have mercy. I say it one more time. Say, it's for you in 2011. My God. I feel like preaching to myself because there were some things that tried to carry on with me in 2011, but there's some things that I told you are not allowed to walk across this line, to walk over this threshold with me. Put your neighbor and say, God's got new for you. Can I just talk about your new? In order for it to be a new event, if there's an order for there to be a new circumstance, in order for there to be this decade of destiny, in order for your atmosphere to change, because everybody's looking for the atmosphere to change, everything's going to do right. And before any of that can happen, you want to know something? God's got to make a new you. Touch your neighbor and say, God's got to make a new you. Stop focusing on the person to the left or to the right. Touch your neighbor and say, God got to make a new me. Y'all quiet in here today. Sometimes you got to shut yourself away so God can make a new you. Touch your neighbor and say, God's got to make a new me. God's got to give me a new power. He's got to give me a new authority. He's got to give me all of these things. Isn't that right? But guess what? He can't make a new you until you forgive yourself about what you took yourself through. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, you got got to forgive yourself. See, from the time you were born to 2010, some of y'all have been looking for other people to forgive you. You've been looking for all this, I'm sorry, and all this, and all that, and when are they going to come to their senses, and all of this kind of stuff. But they don't matter nothing until you forgive yourself. Y'all quiet in here. Let your neighbor say, I got to forgive myself. And there's some inner stuff that is happening on the inside of you that you refuse to deal with because that's the stronger devil in your life. Y'all quiet in here today. Let your neighbor say, I got the stronger devil on the inside of me. Don't matter how much they talk about you, guess what? You can be your worst enemy. And until you learn how to deal with yourself, you can't have that decade of destiny that you were talking about. I feel like preaching in here. Get up off of my back. Touch your neighbor and say, forgive yourself. Y'all quiet in here today. You have taken yourself through some of the worst heartache, through some of the worst travail, through some of the worst times in your life, and God says, in order for you to get through it, you've got to let it go by forgiving yourself. All quiet in here, but I could dance right there. Because some of y'all just need to go ahead and tell yourself, I'm sorry. I'm sorry I dealt with that person that I knew I shouldn't have been dealing with. I'm sorry that I mishandled this situation that I knew I mishandled.